Hello to everyone in Bio33. This is my presentation on a unique and fascinating class of disorders known as agnosia. The word agnosia comes from the Greek word agnousia, meaning ignorance or without knowledge. Agnosia is a general term used to describe any disorder which impedes one's ability to recognize or interpret sensory stimuli, despite having perfectly functional senses. People with various forms of agnosia may experience challenges in recognizing objects, faces, sounds, shapes, smells, locations, the passing of time, or even parts of their own bodies. Symptoms of agnosia most commonly arise following stroke, neurological illness, or brain injury which damages particular cortical areas known as association areas. Each hemisphere of the brain or cerebral cortex has four lobes: frontal, temporal, parietal, and occipital lobes. These contain all of the brain's primary sensory areas as well as all of its association areas. Most sensory information must first pass through the thalamus before being directed to the appropriate primary sensory area of the brain. Here, the brain determines what is being perceived. This information is then relayed to an adjacent association area. Here, the brain analyzes the stimulus and figures out what it means. For example, when you look at a picture of a circle, your eyes send a signal which ultimately reaches the primary visual cortex of your brain located in your occipital lobe. Here, your brain notes things like shading, edges, size, etc., and sends this information to association areas, which interpret this information and recognizes the object as a circle. People affected by agnosia may be able to describe the object they're looking at as being round, smooth, or dark because their vision is not impeded at all. Instead, damage to association areas of their brain prevent them from recognizing the object as a circle. There are many different types of agnosia, at least 26 that I could find, which affect all conceivable modalities. But perhaps the most famous forms of agnosia involve brain areas responsible for forming and understanding language. Portions of the frontal and temporal lobes of the brain, known as Broca's and Wernicke's areas, play an essential role in understanding, planning, and generating speech or written language. These areas are normally found on the left cerebral hemisphere. People who sustain damage to a small region of their left frontal lobe, known as Broca's area, can understand language, but have difficulty speaking, and sometimes even exhibit challenges when writing, typing, or using sign language. This disorder is commonly known as Broca's aphasia. Wernicke's aphasia occurs in people who experience lesions on Wernicke's area, located in the posterior portion of the left temporal lobe. These people are able to speak, but produce nonsensical sentences, often referred to as a word salad. In patients with extreme epilepsy who undergo surgical severing of the corpus callosum, a procedure known as a corpus callosotomy, exhibit a form of agnosia, which is known as a split brain effect. Because the bridge connecting the two hemispheres is cut, the two hemispheres function completely independently of one another. A person with a split brain may appear and act perfectly normally, but when a word is placed in their left field of vision, they are unable to read it. This is because sensory information from your left field of vision is sent to the primary visual cortex of the right hemisphere, and without a corpus callosum, the signal cannot be relayed to the language centers, which are located on the left hemisphere of the brain. Another example of agnosia is called prosopagnosia, also known as face blindness or facial agnosia. This is caused by lesions to the fusiform face area of the brain located on the ventral surface of the temporal lobe. People affected by facial agnosia are unable to process faces and are even unable to recognize the faces of those closest to them, such as their family members. There is no definite cure for agnosia, as brain damage is normally irreversible, but there are ways to cope with the disorder. Therapy can help those affected learn how to supplement their impaired sense by using other modalities, such as touch, hearing, and even memory, to fill in gaps in their perception.